Welcome. Welcome, everyone. Please allow me to make introductions. This gentleman you see is Director Isaac Feldman, the head of Fenrir Intelligence.
So, you're the new captain of the Blood Special Forces. Rather younger than I imagined you'd be. Well, no matter. As the director allowed, I am Isaac Feldman, the eyes and ears of Fenrir's intelligence branch.
Director Feldman, if you'd like to go over the details?
Of course. It's a simple matter. Fenrir Intelligence is here to stake claim to the Spiral Tree. We intend to name it as Sacred Ground.
Sacred Ground?
A region managed in name by Fenrir and its affiliates, but shared amongst all of humanity. It will be free. Once the designation begins, and the details are cut through, as it were, Fenrir will construct a research center and begin studying.
So, strip away the bureaucratic red tape, and what you're really doing is stealing away the Spiral Tree from the Far East branch.
Oh, you believe so? All we intend is to get some real research done. Sacred Ground is no place for kids to play amateur scientists. For years now, Headquarters has had almost no say in the actions of the Far East. We've had no control over this war's front line. And I tell you now, Fenrir Intelligence does not intend to remain in the dark. I assume there is no objection to that, Doctor?
You have something to say?
Dr. Somer, your research has been stalled for a while now. Think of the bright side. Now you'll have a partner as eager for answers as you. Ah, and Captain. Director Feldman has asked for your help. With the two of you working together, you're sure to solve the Spiral Tree's mysteries.
I've only heard good things about your blood unit. Your help could be instrumental. Let's see if you live up to the hype. Observe. The Spiral Tree is a massive collection of active oracle cells. In essence, an origami built on an impossible scale. Our studies naturally disrupt this massive cell. In order to keep it stable, and our scientists safe, we need to position control devices. Your objective is to serve as escorts for the God Ark soldiers that will be moving the devices. We don't know what awaits us. Now then, have you any questions about your task?
Yeah. What about Julius? He's still inside that tree sealing the apocalypse. Is he gonna be all right if we start digging through?
I assure you, we are fully cognizant of Captain Visconti's situation. We will not allow any harm to come to him, if it can be avoided. We believe his presence inside helps to maintain the balance. If the tree's energy is shifted or altered, the whole thing could collapse. Keeping all our citizens safe is the main reason Fenrir wishes to claim the tree. So, Gaudi, any other questions?
No, sir. Understood, Director.
Excellent. Now, Corporal Collette. Step forward.
Yes, sir.
Blood is hereby recommissioned as a division serving Fenrir Intelligence under Corporal Livy Collette. There is no room for failure in this mission. Dismissed.
It's good to see you, Captain. How are you? Do you have a moment to talk? I'm very glad to see that you and Sheel are doing well. A lot happened since I was recalled to HQ, but I've been trying to make amends where I can. Director Feldman invited me to participate in this operation, and I knew it was my best chance to fix things. Fenrir decided to refocus on manned God Ark soldiers. Not a bad decision, and I'm the best specialist they have. I am looking forward to working alongside you, Captain. I thought you'd ask. I'm sure the rogue unmanned soldiers are still rampaging outside the den. The autonomous control drove those soldiers over the edge. Manned ones are far less risk. Manned soldiers have limitations, of course. But now, anyone with training can pilot one. Most important, a human is always in control. I will not have another disaster on my watch. I swear to you. Busy. Constantly. After testifying about Rachel and Fryer, I was finally allowed to go home for a short while. I had to freeze the God Ark soldier program. So much for my family's noblesse oblige. There was barely time for sleep, let alone time with my grief. I kept insisting I'd retire. That barely got me through the day. I'll stop after the trial, I said. After my research is done. Just goes to show you, here I am, back in the Far East, overseeing the God Ark soldier programs. I keep hoping I'll find some closure here. That tree is just a mausoleum for my sister. Director Grimm is tough. No, not like you. He's a survivor in many ways. When all was said and done, he laid the blame on Rachel and Julius. Won a ton of compensation. That's how he got the God Ark soldier program restarted. But Feldman's in charge now. Thank you. You always were dependable. I appreciate you hearing me out. By the by, Dr. Cujo is back on Fryer as well. He's assisting me in the labs. He was torn up when my sister died. It may help if you could be kind to him. I know you.
Everything has been arranged. It seems we're ready to begin testing the device.
Acknowledged. The area around the spiral tree is secure. Preparations complete.
Good. Now, let it begin.
Far East reporting, Director Feldman. We're beginning the monitor sync. Fryer, are we all green?
Fryer reporting. All bias field pulses around the spiral tree are within normal parameters.
Dr. Cujo, please verify.
What? Yes, normal. I mean, everything is functioning.
Control device function confirmed. Sync preparations complete. Go ahead.
Copy.
Director Feldman, how should we time your sync interval?
5 seconds should suffice. I want to be updated the moment you get a new reading. Understood?
Sir.
There's a strange reading coming from device 5.
Fryer report. Can you confirm this reading? What's your opinion, Dr. Cujo?
Well, based on the pattern, it's likely just the physical layer, Director, sir. Nothing more. Nothing to worry about.
I am not worried. Perhaps an origami got a hold of the connecting cable. Damn nuisance. Corporal Livy, head to Fryer and confirm the state of control device 5 and the other cables. I want this handled immediately.
At your command. Blood Captain, you're with me. We'll depart in 10 minutes.
Man, these shifts are just endless. I wish I had the day off today.
You and me both. I haven't had a break since we got out here.
It's tough for sure. But Dr. Lan, Dr. Cujo have been working round the clock. Me? I'd snap under that pressure.
Without a break, they'll go crazy. Hey, is it time for the ceremony?
I am honored to work with the Far East on this grand endeavor. Together, we can stride into history and change this world. Great sacrifices have already been made in the name of progress. Captain Julius Visconti and Dr. Rachel Claudius gave up their lives to erect the spiral tree, to bless this land with fertility once more. This beautiful, hallowed tree serves as mankind's strongest bastion. Keeping at bay the threat of apocalypse forever. Now humanity can stand again as one, free from terror, destruction, and origami. Humanity will survive!
Wow. They're really loving it.
Yeah. The director certainly has a knack for these sorts of things.
It is in honor of their beloved memory, of those that fell in service of the greater good, that we dedicate this shining tree, our sacred ground. We of Fenrir hereby swear to defend humankind's beautiful bastion.
What the devil is that? Spin the choppers and evacuate the civilians. I need all the intel in my hands as soon as possible. You have 30 minutes at most. Get going.
We'll keep the briefing short. As regards to the change in the spiral tree, we can't even gain access to the outer edges. The investigation won't be easy. All we know is that the shift was brought about by an outside catalyst. Moreover, Julius's singularity response has disappeared from all our scans.
Did something happen to him? Is the devouring apocalypse gonna push through?
Most likely, though we have no real way of knowing.
If so, there may not be much time left.
I'm considering alternative measures to resolve this situation effectively. We'll continue to scour the exterior for any clues we can find, as well as commencing an operation to enter the tree.
Seriously? You want to go inside that thing?
I wish to put my theory to the test. I could explain it, but it's better to show you. Please, join me on Friar. Livy, please stand by until everything is prepared.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I know that God Ark.
Yes, Julius's. And with any luck, our key to the spiral tree. Do you know what must be done with a God-Eater who has fallen to the origami infection?
Yes, sir.
I think everyone in the Far East knows how to handle that. With some exceptions.
The best way to protect lives is to eradicate the rogue infected with their own God Arc. Hence, if the Spiral Tree is somehow still Julius after infection by the Apocalypse, the only way to create an entrance is to carve one out with his own God Arc.
Great plan, except it's impossible to use someone else's God Arc.
Normally true. That is, except for her.
Director Feldman, we've accessed Julius's God Arc. It should be ready, sir.
Livy, if you are prepared, please begin. Livy has several bias factors within her, and is unique in that she can bond with any God Arc. Once she has completed the process and become one with Julius's Arc, she can cut us a path into the tree.
20% compatibility, sir.
Excellent. Livy, you may stop. Battle experience will be required to increase compatibility further.
Understood.
Captain, I understand you possess the Evoke ability. I am told it increases the power of God Arcs and allows the wielder to learn unique talents. Good. Accompany Corporal Livy on the exterior scouting. Help her to acquire a blood art. She'll need the full power of Julius's Arc if we're to have a chance of entering the tree. I trust you know what's at stake.
Livy reporting. Target has been sighted. Commencing primary execution tactics.
Are your blood arts advancing, Livy?
Yes, sir. I'm transitioning rather well.
Very good. Describe for me in detail the effect of the captain's blood power. What does this evoke entail?
It seems a form of resonance, sir. It's close to the one seen with second generation God Arcs.
That is all?
I'm not truly a member of blood. I cannot learn more.
Any rejections?
Nothing I can't handle, sir. However, I will likely require a stabilizer eventually.
They're useless if you've already passed the threshold. Livy, you must be careful. Please.
Understood.
All numbers within normal limits. It's time to go to work.
Let the mission commence.
Nagami retreating to feed. What else? Your burst status is fading. Operation complete. That wasn't too bad, right?
They all come home. That's a win for me.
It's over. Keep an eye on your surroundings, even if you think yourself safe.
Who's got two thumbs and just finished a mission? This guy.
I hope we can keep this win streak going.
Wait, that sound. Something's coming. Are you awake? I apologize, Captain. I held you back. I'll make amends. Nothing but static on the comms. I suppose we must be pretty far down. We need to make it to the surface. My bias factor may run out soon.
What do you say, Livy? Wanna fight our way out of here?
your surroundings, even if you think yourself safe.
Okay, we're gonna have a bad time with this one. Yeah, screw it. We end up failing though. A little help, Livy?
Can you stand?
Thanks, Livy. You know what? I do not care anymore. I just want this thing dead. Yes, time for revenge.
Not bad.
Here's the question. Can you die already?
Are you all right? Yes, I'm quite well, thank you. No, not much. You are full of questions. Not that I'm angry to hear you ask. It's simply... you remind me of someone I knew a long time ago. It's here. Stay sharp.
Hey, Libby, cue the music. It's like the gods came and matched the Reapers of Fenrir.
Let's go!
Captain Julius. He's alive. Somewhere inside the tree.